Ma'am, you can turn on your video. We are just about to start the session. Ma'am, am I audible to you? Hello, ma'am. Guys, ma'am is facing some technical glitch, so she will join us in 5 minutes. Meanwhile, have some patience, please. Before we start the session, I have a small request to make to you that you can post your questions in the chat box, and towards the second half of the session, ma'am will try to take up all your queries. Okay, ma'am, we are about to begin the session.
Hello. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you. A wholehearted good evening to everyone. I, Tanu Jagar, the General Secretary of NISHTHA, extend a warm and hearty welcome to all the attendees and to ma'am. In the 7th consecutive day of our edifying event, Avikshit, which means something that is unique and never seen before. We at NISHTHA believe in furnishing an enticing learning experience for the civil services aspirants to make their journey of preparation a stimulating and enriching one. I'm highly jubilant to introduce our distinguished guest, Ms. Nidhi Kaushik, who aced this much sought after exam in her third attempt. And it's a matter of great pride for all of us that Ms. Kaushik is an alumna of Hansraj College. After having completed her graduation and post-graduation in chemistry, ma'am furthered on her journey of cracking this exam, which culminated in her securing an All India rank 286 this year. The entire fraternity of NISHTHA and Hansraj College extend their congratulations for this well-deserved achievement of yours, ma'am. Today, ma'am will throw some light on her journey from Hansraj College to UPSC. With these words of mine, I would like to invite Nidhi ma'am to mark the commencement of this exceptionally illuminating conversation. Thank you, and over to you, ma'am.
Hi. I'm extremely honored and grateful to have this opportunity to share my journey with all of you. As I can remember a quote from Hannah Simone, who is a British-Canadian actress. So there she said that it's always exciting to share something that you love to with more people. And on this note, I would like to extend my heartfelt thank you to invite me here on this event. And I will be able to share my views, my experience, and my journey with all of you. Starting with my journey as an aspirant from Hansraj College, I think I can say that it has all been worth it. And I can say that it has been very enriching, very fulfilling, and very learning experience for me as well for this entire journey. Before starting my session, I would like to you to play a video that I gave to Shresh. Could you play that video? Or I can, if I am the host of the session.
Now, my class, you will learn to think for yourselves again. You will learn to savor words and language.
No matter what anybody tells you, words and ideas can change the world. We don't read and write poetry because it's cute. Read and write poetry because we are members of the human race, and the human race is filled with passion. And medicine, law, business, engineering, these are noble pursuits and necessary to sustain life. But poetry, beauty, romance, love, these are what we stay alive for. Questions of these recurring, of the endless trains of the faithless, of cities filled with the foolish. What good amid these, O me, O life? Answer, that you are here. Life exists and identity. That the powerful play goes on and you may contribute a verse. Will your verse be? You must strive to find your own voice, because the longer you wait to begin, the less likely you are to find it at all. Thoreau said most men lead lives of quiet desperation. Don't be resigned to that. Break out. Conformity, the difficulty in maintaining your own beliefs in the face of others. Now, those of you, I see the look in your eyes like, I would have walked differently. Well, ask yourselves why you are clapping. We all have a great need for acceptance, but you must trust that your beliefs are unique, your own, even though others may think them odd or unpopular, even though the herd may go, that's bad. Robert Frost said, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference.
So if I asked you about art, you'd probably give me the skinny on every art book ever written. Michelangelo. I know a lot about him. Life's work, political aspirations, him and the Pope, sexual orientation, the whole works, right? I bet you can't tell me what it smells like in the Sistine Chapel. You never actually stood there and looked up at that beautiful ceiling. seen that. If I ask you about women, you'll probably give me a silver, say your personal favorites. You may have even been laid a few times. But you can't tell me what it feels like to wake up next to a woman and feel truly happy. When I ask you about war, you'd probably throw Shakespeare at me, right? Once more into the breach.
Could you reverse to the, like, back to the screen? Yeah. So that's how I want to start my journey of civil services. That no matter what anybody tells you, there would be people who will tell you that you can't do it. And there will be everyone around you who will tell you that, okay, it's not your cup of tea. However, it's your own belief. It's your own journey. It's your own story that is going to shape you and take you where you will be. So starting my journey, that I come from a very small town called as Mutal, which is in district Sonipat, called as Haryana. And as we all know that when I came to Delhi, I came to understand the harsh realities and the great divide between the rural and the urban India. And as such, as we all know that Haryana is a state which is very infamous for being a state for very low sex ratio and at the same time a very high economic GDP, or we can say development, in the Haryana state. But I have been very fortunate that I got to this opportunity that I could learn and study in such an institute where I could pursue my journey of being a civil servant. And when I was growing up, because I am telling this journey as a context so that you can understand where I was coming from, where I'm coming from, and you can also relate to certain facts that many of you might be coming from villages where you might not be having enough of facilities, where you might not be having enough of resources at your disposal so that you can make a road for yourself, you can make a journey for yourself. So in this context, I understood that there are certain limitations and there will always be limitations and you have to make the most out of it. So when I came here to Hansraj College, I understood that this is it, because before that I was preparing for JEE and I could not make to IIT. So that was one major setback at that time. And I was not very happy during that time. However, that taught me a lot. And after that, when I came to college, just like anybody, I had also thought that, okay, I'll be doing an MBA and this was the path that everyone comes here and decide for themselves. But at the same time, I think it's our own story, it's our own experiences which will take us to, you know, that will take you to fulfill your destiny. So while I was in my first college, first year of my college, so at that time, we used to go for the evening walks with my friend. And I got to know that there were some kids, you know, at those street lights who were not studying, who were begging there. So we asked them that, okay, what do you do apart from doing this in the evening? So they told me that, okay, we sometimes go to school and we sometimes don't go to school. And this is how our parents tell us that, okay, it's okay to beg. But what we did, I think this is the smallest of the acts that somehow changes people's lives. And at the same time, it changes your life as well. And that was the first step towards civil services that I can remember. And before the one incident that my father inspired me during my childhood to pursue civil services. So at that time, we used to taught them. So we started teaching them that, okay, you can't do this. And so after that, I came to second year. I joined an organization called as Make a Difference. Because at that time, I thought that the impact was quite limited. था दो चार बच्चों को लेके. सो आई शिफ्टेड टू दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कॉल्ड एज मेक अ डिफरेंस. एंड उसके बाद मेरे को वहां पे जो था एक प्लेटफॉर्म मिला. उस प्लेटफॉर्म में मेरे को समझ में आया कि जो दो बच्चे मेरे को वहां पे मिले थे जिनको मेरे को पढ़ाना होता था वीकेंड पे, मेरे को वहां जाना होता था. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट आई हैड सर्टेन अदर रोल्स एज वेल. उसमें अवेयरनेस कैंपेन्स होते थे, जैसे मेक अ डिफरेंस में कुछ बैकथॉन था एक लिटरेसी कैंपेन को लेके. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट जो बच्चे शेल्टर होम्स में रहते थे उनको लेके काफ़ी कुछ कुछ आप करते हो, जैसे उनका ड्रीम कैंप वगैरह ऑर्गेनाइज कराते हैं. सो एट दैट टाइम आई स्टार्टेड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट ओके देर आर सर्टेन थिंग्स इन योर लाइफ विच विल हेल्प यू टू बी वेयर यू आर मेंट टू बी. So that was another incident that shaped me and my journey that, okay, I am meant for this. I want to do something else. And I started and I made my mind that, okay, I want to pursue my journey for the civil services. So after that, after my college, I decided that, okay, I'll prepare for civil services. And that was how the final decision was taken. Obviously, the decision was a very easy one. सबके लिए होता है कि डिसीजन लेना तो बहुत आसान होता है, लेकिन उसके बाद जो जर्नी होती है उस पर स्टैंड करना, उस पर परस्यू करना, दैट इज वेयर द रियल चैलेंज लाइज. सो दैट्स हाउ माय जर्नी बिगेन टू सिविल सर्विसेज आफ्टर माय कॉलेज बिफोर मूविंग हियर एंड देयर लाइक टू ट्राइंग फॉर एमबीए, टू ट्राइंग फॉर मल्टीपल अदर जॉब्स एज वेल वेयर ऑब्वियसली आई समवेयर आई सक्सीडेड एंड समवेयर आई डिडंट सक्सीड. आई एम टेलिंग ऑल दिस टू टेल यू दैट somehow in this journey we fail to accept our failures as well. You know what happens that when I failed in my first prelims, I thought that this is the end of the world and I can't do it again and I won't be doing this exam, that this has taken everything out of me and I might not be doing it again. That's how it started, but this is where the real challenge lies. So then I think I can explain how the real challenges began. So the first major challenge was the misguidance in my preparation. That misguidance in the sense, there were not many people to tell me how to start, from where to start and why to start and how to, you know, just to be on this path. That's it. It is okay to fail. So I would like to thank you here, like to the society, civil services society. As I met Rama ma'am today, I was telling her this only, that, you know, I found out that people from IIT Delhi are having this amazing platform that they have their seniors to tell them, okay, you can do this. And apart from that, they have this unique society. There is very good peer group. They have this library. So this is how I want to thank Nishtha as well, that, you know, keep up the good work. Because at that time, at my time, I faced this challenge that there was a lot of misguidance and there was nobody to tell me. And I think just keep up this good work, keep following the work that you are doing and keep speaking. Okay, so now coming to the next point with regard to the misguidance, I would like to tell students that somehow we take this decision of doing or joining the civil services kyunki baaki log kar rahe hain. Because civil services ek aisa exam nahi hai jisme aap isliye kar rahe ho ki baaki log bhi wahi kar rahe hain, ya aapke parents ne bol diya, ya aapke peer pressure mein aap aake ye kar rahe ho, aap society ke pressure mein aake aap ye kar rahe ho. Because इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आपका वाई क्लियर हो, कि आप सिविल सर्विसेज में आना क्यों चाहते हो. बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इट हैपेंस दैट वी स्टार्ट आर जर्नी बट वी फेल टू रिमेन ऑन द पाथ, वी फेल टू परसिवियर, टू डेडिकेट विद अटमोस्ट ऑनेस्टी एंड डेडिकेशन विद पेशेंस. बिकॉज पेशेंस इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वॉच यू हेयर. बिकॉज जर्नी इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी लॉन्ग. इट्स नॉट लाइक कि आज एग्जाम है कल रिजल्ट आया एंड दैट्स हाउ यू विल बिकम अ सिविल सर्वेंट. रादर एक साल का प्रिपरेशन, दो साल का प्रिपरेशन विल गो इन टू दिस एंड अगेन आपका जो एग्जाम का फेज होगा फिर वो भी एक साल का होगा. तो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोज एंड कॉन्स कि आप किस चीज में एंटर कर रहे हैं एंड आप क्यों एंटर कर रहे हैं और आप कैसे करेंगे. तो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू एनालाइज एवरीथिंग व्हेन यू कम इनटू द सिविल सर्विसेज का प्रिपरेशन. आई आल्सो डिडंट रियलाइज एट दैट टाइम दिस इज द मिस्टेक दैट आई मेड व्हेन आई वाज देयर इन माय स्टार्टिंग ऑफ द जर्नी. सो आई थिंक ये एक वाई आप अगर आप क्लियर करेंगे तो आपका जो हाउ होगा कि वो कैसे करना है फिर वो काफी इजी हो जाता है कि आप उस पाथ पे कैसे खुद को सस्टेन करें. उसके बाद जो एक मेजर चैलेंज आता है सिविल सर्विसेज की जर्नी में वो होता है एक्सेप्टेंस, कि आपको कई बार जो है सेल्फ बिलीफ वाला जो फैक्टर होता है वो नहीं होता है. आपको लगता है कि शायद आप नहीं कर सकते हो. जो लोग सिविल सर्विसेज क्लियर करते हैं वो पता नहीं कैसे लोग होते हैं या फिर दे आर बेटर देन मी. But at the same time, it's very important that you understand that it's okay. It's very doable thing. It's not something out of the world. It's just like you and me, people like us, who do and crack this examination. So what matters is your perseverance and your dedication, that you will put your 100% into it. You will put your everything while you will come into this. And at the same time, kya hota hai ki jab hum preparation kar rahe hote hain, hum sochte hain ki yaar kal hum karenge to ye successful hum honge ki nahi honge, hum fail to nahi ho jayenge. Us pros and cons or success or failure ke definition ke chakkar mein, what we do is we fail to live today. We don't understand what is tomorrow is our today. What we are writing is today will be our story tomorrow, that we are going to, you know, experience it tomorrow, which is our future. Sometimes we say that today, what is present is today only. However, it's not like that. What is today was your past, what you did yesterday. And what you will do today will be your future. So make sure that you, what you are doing today, you give your 100% to it. Rather than procrastinating things that, okay, I'll do things like that, I might fail, and X, Y, Z things that we think in this journey. So that is also how we have to take this exam. Another thing that I made mistake while I was preparing, that I thought that, okay, civil services examination is the only thing that I have to do, and civil services is the life. It's just an exam, and take this journey as an exam only. There are opportunities beyond this, because now the world is changing, and you have to analyze this fact as well, that the seats are also declining consistently, and many opportunities are also growing in other sectors as well. So make sure that you, you know, link your preparation with other aspects as well, in what kind of circumstances you are in, what kind of preparation you want to do, what kind of future you are aspiring for, what kind of journey you are looking for. So it's very important that you enjoy your journey. Ki aap ki jo journey hai na, I think main aaj ye yahan pe aake main bol sakti hu ki safar khoobsurat hai manzil se bhi. And it's actually very true. Jab aap wahan hote ho na, to aapko lagta hai wo jo disheartenment, depressed feelings hoti hain ki aap nahi kar pa rahe ho. But now I look back, when I connect the dots, I think the journey was very beautiful. It was the most beautiful phase of this entire preparation. Jisse aap bante hue actually mein ki aap story jab aap batate ho na ki kal ko ki jab aap successful ho jayenge ki aapki story kya hai. You know, you fail, you stand, you fail, you again stand. So this is your story is. This is where the real experience lies in. So it's okay to fail sometimes, and we have to accept that as well. Ki एक और फैक्टर आता है कि कभी कभी हम अपनी जो आइडेंटिटी है वो इस एग्जाम से लिंक कर लेते हैं कि हमारा नहीं होगा तो सोसाइटी क्या सोचेगी, या फिर यू नो नैरो डेफिनेशंस ऑफ सक्सेस दैट वी क्रिएट. सो आई थिंक दैट इज आल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू डोंट क्रिएट योर आइडेंटिटीज विद द एग्जाम, विद दिस एग्जाम और एनी अदर थिंग दैट यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर. वट यू हैव टू डू इज लाइक थिंक बियॉन्ड द नैरो डेफिनेशंस of, you know, successful or not being successful. क्योंकि कभी कभी जो सबसे important learnings होती हैं वो आपके failures में ही होती हैं. अगर आप fail नहीं होते, आप शायद से वो successful को जो successful होने का जो मजा है वो भी शायद आप नहीं ले पाएंगे. अगर आप fail नहीं होंगे तो आपको समझ नहीं आएगी कि उसकी value क्या है, उसका worth क्या है, वो भी नहीं समझ में आएगा. So it's very important that we understand कि ये जो जर्नी है उसको भी हम उतना ही इक्वल रिस्पेक्ट करें. बेसिकली वी हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट दिस जर्नी, यू नो. सो वो भी एक करना है. फिर एक बात आती है कि एग्जाम से रिलेटेड, की मेरी जर्नी से रिगार्डिंग. तो जर्नी का अगर मैं बोलूं तो ग्रेजुएशन के बाद जब मैंने किया और डिसीजन लिया कि सिविल सर्विसेज का, एंड मेनी पीपल आस्क कि मैम हम फर्स्ट ईयर से अपना तैयारी शुरू कर देते हैं सिविल सर्विसेज को ज्वाइन करने के लिए. बट आई थिंक सी यू हैव जस्ट एंटर्ड कॉलेज, यू माइट बी अ फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट, एंड एट द सेम टाइम यू माइट बी समवन हु इज ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर लाइक इन फाइनल ईयर, हु इज ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर 2-3 years नाउ. But at the same time, I just want to give this important message ki college life is the most important phase which shape your personality, which shape who you are, which is going to determine what kind of memories you are taking from your college. So I think it's very important ki aap college life ko bhi equally enjoy karein. Because civil services is not just about ki aap padhai kar rahe hain and then we become a civil servant. I also started after college, and I talked to Shruti. She started in her last year. So you know, we have different kind of journey, and she did it in her second attempt. So, which is very, you know, a guiding light for other people as well. Ki it's okay to start in the last year as well. You don't need to start in the very first year as well. कि आते ही आपको बस कि सिविल सर्विसेज का एक मकसद लेके आप आ रहे हैं ना, तो वो चीज भी ठीक नहीं है. आपको कॉलेज को इक्वली रिस्पेक्ट करना है कि आप कॉलेज में जो भी आप सीख के जा रहे हैं उसको इक्वली आपको डेडिकेशन के साथ करना है, क्योंकि दीज थिंग्स आर गोइंग टू स्टे विद योर लाइफ, नॉट जस्ट दिस एग्जाम वाला प्रिपरेशन बट अदर थिंग्स एज वेल. यू हैव टू मेक योर पर्सनैलिटी एज अ होल, बिकॉज सिविल सर्विसेज का एग्जाम इज नॉट जस्ट अबाउट अ जॉब, इट्स मोर अबाउट योर पर्सनैलिटी, हु यू आर. इट्स गोइंग टू टेस्ट नॉट जस्ट योर नॉलेज बट योर इंटेलेक्ट बट योर पेशेंस एज वेल. काफी सारे एस्पेक्ट्स हैं इसमें जो इम्पोर्टेंट हैं, जो आपको डिटरमाइन करेंगे. और उसके बाद बात आती है कि खुद का जो एक विश्वास है. आई वॉज अ वेरी शाई किड and I was a person who didn't believe in myself. I always needed a constant support from my parents, my friends, that, you know, I always thought that, okay, I can't do this and I can't make it to the list. But, you know, this was the attempt, I can say, that where I believed in myself truly, that, okay, I can do this. Because when I reached last year to the, you know, to the interview stage, at that time, I realized that whole time I was busy thinking about the results, about being successful or not, about failing the exam, what would I do in my life. You know, these are the kind of thoughts that we usually have when we are preparing for civil services. And I also had similar kind of, you know, challenges. So at that time, I thought that, okay, I can't do this and I won't make it. So, but when I could not make it to the list last time, when I gave interview last year, so there was this slight realization, it's very important that you believe in yourself, no matter what world tell you, ki aap nahin kar payenge. When I started my journey, you know, I want to tell this incident, ki when I started my journey, I thought that I'm very bad at writing. I can't write answers, I can't write essays, I'm good at chemistry. But when I see my results today, I scored very low in chemistry and I scored one of the highest score in GS paper. So that's how destiny is. And that's how you underestimate yourself sometimes and you overestimate sometimes. So it's okay to accept your strengths as well as your weaknesses. It's very important that you understand what your strengths and weaknesses are. Because when people tell you now that, okay, that you have to understand what are your weaknesses, what are your strengths, and you have to work on your strengths and you have to work on your weaknesses, sometimes we fail to realize that, as I could not, because I could not understand that GS or essay, that writing is my forte rather than this subject. So we have to understand this as well. And another thing, because we have so many things at our you know, disposal, we have so much of resources, we have so many YouTube videos, we try to get you know, motivated, we can say, as well as sometimes demotivated as well. And we try to link our journey with different things. We start to compare ourselves with different people, you know, who are not, who have not experienced what we have. So it's very important that you understand where you are coming from. It's very important कि आपको ये पता चलना चाहिए कि आपको जाना कहाँ है. और अगर आप कंपैरिजन कर रहे हैं ना, कभी भी हॉरिजॉन्टली वो कंपैरिजन नहीं करना है कि अच्छा साथ वाला इंसान क्या कर रहा है. Always do it vertically. What you were yesterday and what you will be tomorrow. This is how your comparison should be. Because when I started my journey, obviously I belonged to this, you know, science background, non-medical tha mere paas 11th 12th mein. And then when I came to college, I did my chemistry honors. So when I came, you know, to coaching institute to study polity, I realized that, okay, there's very little that I know. I could not even differentiate between a Lok Sabha and a Rajya Sabha. At that time, I was like that. So it's very important that you realize from where you are coming from. You have to understand ki aapka jo weaknesses hai, wo kya hai, aur aapko kaha jana hai. So jab aap comparison karte hain, which is surely a road to misery, I can tell you that when we are in this journey, we think that, okay, people are getting successful, our friends are getting settling down, and okay, we should also settle down. These kind of thoughts come at that time. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट कि आप जो कंपैरिजन है वो ना करें, और आपको ये देखना है कि आप कहाँ से आ रहे हैं, आपका जर्नी कहाँ है, आपका फाउंडेशन क्या है और आपको कहाँ जाना है. सो इट्स ओके टू टेक मोर देन वन अटेम्प्ट. एंड समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इज ऑन सोशल मीडिया देयर इज दिस ओवर ग्लैमराइजेशन ऑफ यू नो द पीपल हु हैव मेड इट टू द सिविल सर्विसेज. एंड एट द सेम टाइम we have to appreciate that people have made it to civil services, but at the same time we do not have to get disheartened to see the people who are there. We have to just get motivated rather than getting demotivated by them. Okay, so this I can tell you from my experience. These are the small learnings that I have experienced over my 5 long years of preparation journey. And now when I say that it was tough, I can say it was tough, but at the same time I can say it was worth it as well. And another important factor that I would like to tell you, that you have to believe in your teachers as well. Sometimes what we do is we do not believe in our mentors, our teachers, our friends, our guide, whosoever it is. So you have to understand their importance as well. That, you know, sometimes we say things like that, okay, someone is self-made. And aaj jaise jab maine ma'am se baat kiya, to ma'am ne bhi yahi mere ko ek definition bataya ki people term it as self-made people. Rather, it's the people behind us, our parents, our family, our teachers. And there are a lot of other people as well who have supported you in this journey. So I think it's very important ki kaun aapke saath hai. और कौन आपके साथ नहीं है वो भी डिस्टिंग्विश करना इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो आपको ये एक इम्पॉर्टेंट डिस्टिंग्विश करना है इन चीज़ों के बीच में भी कि आपको कैसे कहाँ जाना है और आपके साथ कौन खड़ा है, रादर देन थिंकिंग कि अरे वो तो मेरे फेलियर्स में था ही नहीं, या तो वो तो मेरे सक्सेसफुल होने के बाद मेरे पास आया. सी दे आर डूइंग देयर ओन वर्क. क्योंकि ऐसे होता है जब आप सिविल सर्विसेज की प्रिपरेशन करते हैं, आप अपने रिलेटिव्स को बताते हैं दैट ओके आई एम प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर सिविल सर्विसेज, एंड यू माइट फेल इन प्रीलिम्स एंड दे विल कम टू यू कि ओके ओ यू कुड नॉट मेक इट सो सॉरी, एंड दे विल कम अगेन कि ओके ओ इट्स वेरी सैड. सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज कि यू हैव टू डू योर ओन वर्क रादर देन लिसनिंग टू पीपल देयर ओपिनियंस. सो दिस इज अनदर थिंग. नाउ कमिंग टू द प्रिपरेशन पार्ट, this is about the challenges or other things that I faced and the mistakes that I made. So we can then talk about the preparation. If there are certain questions, we can take them and then we can talk about. Okay Tanu, it's okay? Like regarding the preparation strategy, if we have to talk about that, or I can just say.
No, ma'am.
Okay, is anyone willing to ask a question?
We'll take up the questions. So thank you so much, ma'am, for such an inspiring address. And now we'll move to the question answer part. So ma'am, the very first question is, what is the role that college exposure plays in the journey of preparation for a civil services aspirant in all respects, be it academics or holistic personality development?
Yeah. That is very important question that you touched on, and I wanted to talk about that when I was saying that okay, you can start with the preparation in the first year, but it's okay, it's very important that you understand the importance of the college exposure that it provides you. So there are a lot of competitions that happen during college times, like debate competitions, which will ultimately help you in the personality test. There are other competitions like essay competition as well as sports as well. You know, all these factors cumulatively help you to understand what are your strengths and what are your weaknesses, which I was telling about. And at the same time, it's very important that you participate in all these things, because it will equip you with the challenges that you will face in the coming journey so that you can handle them better. Because it could be a small responsibility from your class representative to a bigger one, to a president of a society. So all these aspects, give you that kind of experience, that kind of learning experience when you will go to the field that no other thing can provide you. So it's very important to participate in the extracurricular activities. And I would suggest everyone strongly and very wholeheartedly ki aap ye kijiye. Isme matlab koi aapko dohraye nahi rakhna hai ki ye to mera padhai ka time jayega. But it's very important to participate in this. College exposure ki agar main baat karun, jaise jab college mein hum the, so there were a lot of debate competitions, MUN as well, where I participated and I got to learn about how UN functions. And then you come to understand that, okay, this is a very essential part, which will help you in the later stages of the preparation. And at the same time, the challenges that you are going to face, you know, sometimes, as I can say, that I was very emotionally a weak person. My EQ was not very strong, but these were the things that helped me to make it strong. So that's how important college exposure is.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. So the other question is, what is your opinion on taking a science subject as optional? Since usually it has been observed that humanities subjects are more preferred for optional papers rather than the science subjects.
Regarding the choosing of optional, it's a very, you know, personal decision. But at the same time, it's a very objective decision that I can say. That, you know, people who have studied or who are coming from the humanities background would be, it would be very difficult to take a science subject, you know, a very new different subject that you would be starting from scratch. But at the same time, for a science student, it might be easy to grasp a new subject from like coming from the humanities, for example, say history or geography, because they have studied that at least till 12th class. And for a subject like chemistry, physics, and maths, I can tell you from my experience with respect to my optional, that was chemistry. And there are certain challenges that I faced during my optional preparation. One, its syllabus is very vast as compared to the other humanities subject. Second, the syllabus overlap is very, very less as compared to other humanities subjects. For example, a public administration or a sociology or a subject like, you know, PSIR, they overlap with the subjects of GS, SA, they will help you there, which might not be the case with the science subjects. And the third major challenge is that the revision part is very difficult with science subjects, which I faced, that you cannot revise your whole syllabus of your graduation and post-graduation in just 7 days, which might be easier for an optional subject of humanities. Right? Apart from that, there are certain very important pros of choosing an optional subject from sciences. One, that you can analyze your performance. It's very objective, while it might not be the case with the humanities wala subject. Other thing is that, you know, it's okay there to, even if you don't attempt like 10-20 marks, like if you get it wrong there, it will be okay because, you know, the marks are given on a higher side. On the side that I can say that you might be awarded a 10/8 in a science subject, you might not be awarded a 10/8 in a humanities subject. So this is the basic difference. And the pros, if you have studied a science subject, it would be very easy for you to start from that subject. But now coming to humanities subject, if you are taking them as an optional, their pros are that they overlap with the GS subject. Like for example, if I tell about PSIR, its subject overlap with the paper 2, GS paper 2. It will help you in the SA paper. It will also help you in the GS 4 paper regarding the examples that you would be quoting in the GS 4. And apart from that, the revision part becomes easier with respect to the humanities subject. And third thing, while you will be preparing for GS, you can understand that better. Because once you enter into the GS preparation, when you prepare for civil services, it becomes very difficult to, you know, match the preparation of two different streams, like science subject and GS subject. However, it would be easier with that, with the humanities subject. So it depends on what kind of, you know, mindset of yours is, what kind of background you are coming from. Suppose if you are from science background, you can take a science technical subject, maths, physics, chemistry. And now also another factor that decides, sometimes we get influenced by the results that, okay, this subject is scoring more, this subject is scoring less. This is not criteria. This should not be the criteria. It totally depends on your performance, on your background, and what kind of mindset you are in or your mindset is. And it's just like a marriage, basically, to your optional, because you have to study it with your heart and soul. And optional is going to decide your rank and your service ultimately. So that is how important your optional subject is. So you have to, you know, please choose your optional very wisely. Take help from anywhere that is possible and everywhere that is possible, and take advice from your seniors as well, that these are the options that you have shortlisted, and make a plan. These are the criteria, these are the subjects. First shortlist 2 to 3 subjects which you are interested in, then look at the syllabus, then look, analyze the previous year question papers, and then come to a point that, okay, this is the optional subject that you have chosen. So that's how you can decide your optional.
Okay. Ma'am, the next question is regarding the current affairs, which is, what was your approach to cover the current affairs? And how many years of current affairs did you keep a tab on?
Okay. So, like, regarding the number of years, first coming to that question, because there is this incident that we usually do 1 year ka current affair. But what happened in 2020 ka GS ka mains paper of paper 3, I can recall that now, that there were some questions regarding the Jal Abhiyan. There were some questions regarding the NCAP, you know, National Clean Air Program. These are the current affairs that happened in 2019, while the exam was in January 2021. So I think it's very important when UPSC says a question, like when it gives a statement and says recently, usually it's 1+1. So it's very important that you study at least 2 years of current affairs, that you are very thorough with the current affairs. Now, coming to my approach regarding the current affairs, what you can do is, just stick to one source. This is the mistake that I made in my initial attempt, that I referred to multiple sources. I thought that, okay, kuch chhoot na jaye. Is chakkar mein, I referred to multiple sources, which obviously ended me up in failing prelims. So this is the mistake that we usually make. We refer to multiple sources and we don't revise it enough. So first point is, stick to one source. Second point is, do ample amount of revision if possible. You know, at least 6 to 7 times you have to revise your current affairs. And the third thing is, make short notes out of it. And fourth thing is, link everything with newspaper. Usually we try to make shortcuts, like we just study current affairs magazine and we don't refer to the newspaper. So what you have to do is read newspaper daily, thoroughly. And also, it's very important that how you are reading newspaper. I can, you know, answer this question as well. Sometimes this is a very major challenging aspect, that, okay, what to read in a newspaper? Should we read it pura ka pura newspaper? What are the aspects that we should look into while reading newspaper? First, sit down with your syllabus and take important notes of your syllabus, that, okay, these are the subjects that you are going to study. Then understand the previous year questions, what kind of questions are asked, and then see in what depth questions are being asked. Like when NCAP question was asked, they specifically asked for the provisions. So that means that you have to deal with, if there is a particular scheme, you have to deal with it thoroughly. You have to see when it came, what are the provisions, what are its aims, what is its vision, क्या वो करना चाहता है, and what its implication would be on you, on government as a whole. So I think this is how you have to go about reading the newspaper. Not everything is important, because usually what happens is that in editorials, what comes is political wala and all that stuff also comes in newspaper. So make sure that you understand the demand of the paper, what UPSC is expecting. You have to understand that as well. तो अपना जो preparation है उसी के according mold कीजिए, कि अपना syllabus को short themes or parts may divide kar lijiye. And regarding newspaper that I referred to, in my initial part of preparation, I referred to the Hindu, but later on I switched to the Indian Express. And I can suggest everyone that we can read in the Indian Express. I found it better as compared to the Hindu in certain aspects of the preparation. However, for the interview stage, you can read 2 to 3 newspapers, because it's very important that you have a good opinion on each of the topics that are revolving in that current scenario. So it should not be a biased opinion. You have a balanced opinion, so that in that stage you can refer to 2 newspapers. But before that, Indian Express is sufficient, I can say. And regarding the current affairs strategy, so I refer to one magazine. I refer to Vision PT365 and Mains 365 for the mains examination. And apart from that, I can suggest that you can also refer to the only IAS videos, the prelims booster discussion that comes on YouTube. You can also refer to them as well. I found them very helpful because earlier, before that, I was not able to clear prelims. However, they helped me a lot. When I refer to them, because what I used to do was I would read Current Affairs magazine and I would revise it from the only IAS YouTube videos. So it was kind of revision that I would do daily. And then comes the, you know, monthly wala ek revision ka video bhi aata hai uska, then you can refer to that so that you can revise your cumulative current affairs of that particular month. And then you can make your short notes. Or you can do another thing, that there is this index on the first page of each of the current affair magazine that you are referring to. Wahin pe apna jo important details hai, like chota chota, wahin uske samne likh lo. So that you know ki ye aapne padha hai aur iske bare mein ye important hai. Kyunki sara important nahi hai. Obviously, there are certain facts that you want to remember. And there are a lot of useless things as well given there. So you can ignore that. And prelim se kuch ek hafta pehle, 10 din pehle, jab aapko revision karna hota, you can refer to that index. That's how you can go for preparing the current affairs.
Okay. Ma'am, one of the attendees want you to share some insights on how to fill the detailed application form efficiently.
Okay. So detailed application form ke regarding, you know, they don't judge you basically what you have achieved till now. They are very fair people, very, you know, cordial people who won't judge you basically on these aspects. And regarding the fact that there are certain columns regarding the, first is regarding the rewards, scholarships, that is the one column that is given there in the DAF. So wahan pe agar aapne school mein ya colleges mein, basically it usually start from the college level. So agar aapne college mein kuch top kiya hai, aap wo likh sakte hain. Jaise I was an Inspire scholar and I topped my chemistry department, so I wrote that there. And apart from that, there is this sports ka column. To usme agar aapne kuch national level pe khela hai, usse upar level pe khela hai, to wo aap usme bhar sakte hain. Because I didn't play any sports wala kuch bhi, to I didn't fill that column. Apart from that, there is this another column jahan pe aap apna hobbies ke bare mein likhte hain. To jo bhi aapka hobby hai, aap usko wahan pe aap usko detail application form mein bhar sakte hain. It could be anything. If you know, like watching movies, you can fill that. They'll ask you questions regarding that. What kind of movies do you like? What kind of, if you love reading books, you can you can enter that thing. Okay, what kind of books do you like to read? So usme aap ye bhar sakte hain. Then there is this another column, I'm forgetting, let me recall. Yes, whatever extracurricular projects that you have done during your college or school life, so you can fill them. So these are the four major columns that are there regarding hobbies. So I think this is the major column that everyone can fill. I think I saw that question ki if one has never achieved anything big in life or never win any competition, you know, it's never important. There is nothing big. It's just that you are participating. That is more important rather than winning. It's not, it's okay to fail. It's okay not to succeed at things. So I think it's very important to understand that aspect as well. And yes, so another column is like your hobbies. So you can fill that.
Okay, thank you so much, ma'am. The next question is, how should we make notes from the standard books? And is it necessary to make notes from newspapers?
Yeah, okay. So coming to your second question, that it's not very important to make notes from newspaper, because usually the current affairs magazines, they cover all the things, usually. Like if there is any major current affairs that is coming there, so that is usually there. So there is no need to make notes from the newspaper. However, what you can do is, if there is any important topic that is there in the newspaper, you can just write that topic and see if that topic is covered in the monthly magazine. So just look at it. And if it is not, by the end of the month, you will have a list of topic. If the most of the topics will be covered in the current affairs magazine, if not, you can Google them. You know, just Google that particular topic again. Just make your notes of only those topics which are not covered there. Pick chota chota list bana lo apne topics ka jo aapne likha hai, rather than writing everything. And at the end of the month, उस दिन आप बैठ जाइए उन सारे topics को लेके और उसके बाद आप detail में उसको discuss कर लीजिए कि ये मेरे को Google से search करना है. And regarding the notes, see, जब mains का paper होता है, so you have very less time between two papers. And the paper जो है वो लगातार होते हैं, essay का paper and then GS 1, 2 and then 3, 4 and then your optional. तो वहां पे गैप नहीं होता है. तो इट्स वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट कि आप ये चीज देखें कि आप कितना रिकॉल कर पाएंगे क्या. मतलब कि अगर सपोज आप कुछ पढ़ते हैं कि आपका मेमोरी किस तरीके का है, आप रिवीजन करने के बाद कितना ज्यादा उसको अपना रिटेन कर पा रहे हैं बेसिकली. What obviously which is humanly impossible to remember all the things, so it's very important कि आप नोट्स बनाएं उस सेंस में. तो अब वहां पे आपका इम्पोर्टेंस आता है शॉर्ट नोट्स का, रादर देन मेकिंग नोट्स ऑफ एवरीथिंग. क्योंकि देखो प्रीलिम्स ऐसा स्टेज है वहां पे थोड़ा डिफिकल्ट है टू मेक नोट्स, टू आइडेंटिफाई यू नो द क्रक्स ऑफ द थिंग्स, एज इन उसमें फैक्ट्स भी आता है, अंडरस्टैंडिंग भी आता है. बट वेन यू राइट आंसर्स देर आर सर्टेन इम्पॉर्टेंट फैक्ट्स विच यू हैव टू एड इन योर आंसर्स. एंड एट द सेम टाइम there is this analytical part while you are answering the GS questions. तो आपको वो दो चीजों को ध्यान में रखते हुए अपने नोट्स को बनाना है. तो prelims के लिए it's not very important कि आप नोट्स बनाएं, but at the same time अगर आप जैसे subjects हैं कुछ, जैसे history है, तो उसमें कुछ dates हैं important और वो आपको याद रखना है, तो उसको आपका आपको उसके नोट्स बनाने होंगे. सपोज environment है, then there are certain acts वहाँ पे, तो उन चीजों के नोट्स बनाने हैं. वहां पे नेशनल पार्क्स, वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज, क्वेश्चन और टू वहां से आते ही है हर साल. तो ऐसी चीजों के हमें प्रीलिम्स से रिगार्डिंग नोट्स बनाने हैं. अदर देन दैट आई वुड सजेस्ट स्ट्रांगली कि आप जो अपना स्टैंडर्ड बुक्स हैं उनको ही रिवाइज करें मल्टीपल टाइम्स, एज मेनी टाइम्स एज पॉसिबल. रादर देन रेफरिंग टू मल्टीपल बुक्स, आई वुड सजेस्ट यू टू रिवाइज वन पर्टिकुलर बुक फॉर मल्टीपल टाइम्स. दिस इज हाउ योर स्ट्रैटेजी शुड बी. And now coming to the mains part, there are a lot of subjects which are usually ignored by all of us. Like in paper 3, we usually ignore disaster, internal security. काफी छोटे subjects हैं, but very important. हर साल हर topics like 2 to 3 questions once you will analyze the paper. तो आपको इन topics के it's very important that you make the notes. हर एक subject को आपको analyze करना है कि आपके weak areas क्या हैं, आपके strong areas क्या हैं. देन आपको सिलेबस को रेफर करना है, देन आप आइडेंटिफाई कीजिए कि थीम्स क्या है. तो जो आपको बुक से कवर हो गया है वो वेल एंड गुड. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इफ यू आर फेसिंग एनी चैलेंज कि आप बुक वापस से नहीं पढ़ पाएंगे, तो फिर आप नोट्स बना लीजिए. और नोट्स बनाने की जो स्ट्रैटेजी है, इट शुड नॉट बी लाइक कि आपने बस बुक से उठा लिया है और आपने फिर सारा ही लिख डाला है. आपको लग रहा है कि हम यूजुअली ट्राई करते हैं कि हम जो इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट है, जब हम फर्स्ट रीडिंग करते हैं तो हमें लगता है कि सब इम्पॉर्टेंट है. But I would suggest you to make notes at least after 2 to 3 readings of the book. क्योंकि उसके बाद आपको आपको पता चलेगा कि what is important for the exam perspective. तो ये चीज बहुत जरूरी है कि आप ये identify कर पाएं कि notes में आपको लिखना क्या है. Because at the end what we do, हम सारा लिख लेते हैं, which is not at all right. तो आपको वो भी identify करना है कि आप देखें कि किस तरीके से करना है. तो this is how you can go for the note making strategy.
Okay. Ma'am, sometimes it happens that when an aspirant is unable to clear the exam in its initial attempts, it leads to a lack of confidence. So can you share with us as to how you dealt with such situation and kept yourself motivated throughout?
So this is exactly what I was talking about, that, you know, two major challenges, self-belief and that comparison that you do with other people. Like I told you not to do that horizontally, rather do it vertically. So that's how I motivated myself during my preparation. I always reminded myself from where I started. So aapko ye dekhna hai ki aap kal kahan the aur aap aaj kahan pe hain. Aapko apne mistakes ko constantly analyze karna hai. आपको देखना है कि अगर सपोज आपके प्रीलिम्स की प्रेपरेशन में कमी रह गई या आप सब्जेक्ट्स को ठीक से नहीं रीड कर पा रहे हैं. देखिए एट द एंड ऑफ द डे इट्स यूजुअली कि जो मिस्टेक है वो हम में ही है, रादर देन somewhere else ki hum blame karte hain ki exam aisa aaya tha aur ye marks nahi mile ya paper kharab ho gaya, you know, we start to blame other things. To wo nahi karna hai. To us scenario mein yahi hai ki we have to identify the mistakes in ourselves and this acceptance has to come ki it's okay ki hamare andar bhi faults ho sakte hain and we have to accept our flaws as well. To un flaws ko jab hum identify karenge, we would be better able to analyze what our mistakes are. तो वो मिस्टेक्स को एनालाइज करने के बाद आप देखोगे कि आपको बिल्ड कहाँ करना है. जैसे व्हेन आई गेव इंटरव्यू लास्ट ईयर एंड आई कुड नॉट मेक इट टू द लिस्ट, आई फाउंड आउट दैट आई वाज लैगिंग इन माय ऑप्शनल सब्जेक्ट, सो आई वर्कड ऑन दैट. एंड बिफोर दैट आई वाज फेलिंग इन प्रीलिम्स, सो आई वर्कड ऑन दैट. सो आपको कॉन्स्टेंटली एनालाइज करना है कि आपकी कमी कहाँ पे रह रही है आफ्टर मल्टीपल अटेम्प्ट्स. और रिगार्डिंग दिस सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस, as I just showed you that video, you know, the major purpose behind that video was that no matter what anybody tells you, no matter what world says to you, no matter how your current life is going on, no matter where you are feeling, it's very important that you believe in yourself. Aur wo self belief kaise aayega, wo aise aayega jab aap din mein apna 100% denge na, jab aap dekhenge ki aapne apna jo bhi apna time table banaya hai, aapne decide kiya hai ki aapko ye char cheeze karni hai aur uske upar aapko build karna hai. So by the end of the day jab aap wo fulfill kar payenge, to you will realize ki aapne apna 100% diya hai aur wahan se aapka jo self confidence hai wo aayega. So that's how you can go. So there's this query from Abhishek Kumar. Ma'am, do you use social media while preparing UPSC? No, I was not using any social media platform while I was preparing because I wasn't using Instagram, Facebook. I had deactivated all my accounts, so I didn't use social media during my preparation. And only WhatsApp was used, obviously, to share like how to, you know, the papers and all that stuff, to share notes as well. So how to maintain discipline while preparing UPSC. Okay, so discipline ke regarding, as I just said, that it's very important ki aap apna ek timetable banaye. And it's very important ki aap jo timetable bana rahe hain wo kafi realistic ho, rather than aap koi bhi unrealistic timetable bana rahe ho. Aap plan kar rahe ho ki aap ye bahut sara books aapne likh liya, ye main finish kar dunga is hafte mein, ye bahut sari cheeze aap kar lenge. So rather than doing that, what you have to do is मेक अ रियलिस्टिक टाइम टेबल और उसी से डिसिप्लिन आएगा. और डिसिप्लिन का मतलब ये नहीं है कि अब आप टाइम टेबल बनाने लग जाएं कि मैं 7 बजे ही उठूंगा और मैं 8 बजे मैं खाना खा लूंगा और मैं 9 बजे पढ़ने बैठ जाऊंगा. इट शुड नॉट बी लाइक दैट. प्लान योर डे विद यू नो, इट शुड बी अ डे फिल्ड विद सम एक्टिविटीज, लाइक इट वुड बी स्पोर्ट्स, एक्सरसाइजिंग, योगा, बिकॉज जर्नी इज गोइंग टू बी वेरी लॉन्ग. And it should be enriching. It should be something that will shape your personality as a whole. So make a timetable जिसमें आपके सारे activities cover हों apart from your studies. और studies का जो timetable है वो काफी realistic होना चाहिए और उसी से आपकी life में discipline आपको लेके आना है. और consistency in the preparation is very important. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि आप आज 10 घंटे पढ़ रहे हैं और कल आप 4 घंटे पढ़ रहे हैं और फिर 4 दिन तक आपने पढ़ाई नहीं किया और फिर आप आके अगेन आप यही कर रहे हैं. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू मेंटेन योर कंसिस्टेंसी. सॉरी, यू आर इनऑडिबल स्मृति.
ऑडिबल नाउ?
या, यू आर ऑडिबल नाउ.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Tanu is facing some technical glitches, so I'd be taking over her. So, ma'am, my next question is, how should we approach the philosophical questions for the ethics paper and what should be the strategy for the same?
Okay. Regarding the philosophical questions, you know, these are the questions that usually comes at the end, those quotes wala question that comes at the end of the paper, like 11, 12, 13 question. So what you have to do for that, there is this theory part where you read about the thinkers like Bentham, Mill, and all their theories. So try to link those theories like deontology or and all that philosophy wala part with examples. So फिलोसफी वाले क्वेश्चन को कैसे अप्रोच करना है, फर्स्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द क्रक्स ऑफ द स्टेटमेंट, देन गिव एन इंट्रोडक्शन, यू नो, समिंग अप दैट अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट यू हैव बिल्ड फ्रॉम दैट स्टेटमेंट, उसी को इंट्रोडक्शन में लिख दीजिए. देन ट्राई टू जस्टिफाई दैट आर्ग्यूमेंट विद एन एग्जाम्पल, और उसी के ऊपर आपको वो एग्जाम्पल आपको बिल्ड करना है. तो वो एग्जाम्पल आप वहां से बिल्ड करेंगे एंड देन ट्राई टू यू नो बिल्ड अ चेन ऑफ थॉट्स देयर, उसी आर्ग्यूमेंट को स्ट्रेंथन करना है विद अदर फिलोसफिकल थॉट्स. इस तरीके से यू कैन अप्रोच द फिलोसफिकल आंसर. यू नो अभी एग्जाम्पल नहीं है, अदरवाइज आई वुड हैव टेल यू कि कैसे, कोई क्वेश्चन के थ्रू इट वुड हैव बीन बेटर कि मैं कैसे कहना चाह रही हूँ. इट्स डिफिकल्ट ऐसे बताना थोड़ा सा कोर्स वाले क्वेश्चन में, बिकॉज लॉट ऑफ थिंकर्स यू हैव टू रीड इन एथिक्स का पेपर. थोड़ा बहुत ज्यादा डीप में नहीं पढ़ना है थिंकर्स को एथिक्स के पेपर के रिगार्डिंग. इट्स नॉट लाइक इट्स योर ऑप्शन कि आपको थिंकर्स कोट करना है. जस्ट हैव अ बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड ट्राई टू substantiate your argument with example. That's how you have to approach all the questions in ethics. Other questions also, try to build on that.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Now this is a question from an anonymous attendee. They're asking how to handle the situation when others have more expectations from you, maybe because you topped in the 12th or graduation, and when you're not able to clear in the very first attempt. So how should we stay positive at that time? Basically, how should we face the society?
So, as I was just telling that, okay, similar kind of expectations were there for me as well, because I topped my 12th examination, I topped in my graduation. So, you know, it just comes as a setback when you don't clear the civil services examination in first attempt. But when I came here, I read about the journey of other people. I read about their experiences, that their journey has been more difficult than me, and I found the motivation from them. So sometimes it's inner motivation and sometimes it's external motivation. And apart from that, there's this famous quote, you know, if you have a why, you can survive anyhow. So ye jo confidence aata hai ki aapko jab why clear hoga na, civil services aapko kyun karna hai, तो इट बिकम्स वेरी इजी कि आपको कैसे करना है, और वहीं से आपके पास वो कॉन्फिडेंस आता है कि इस तरीके से करना है. और अगर आपकी स्ट्रैटेजी जो है, जैसे मैंने बोला कि उसको ये नहीं कि यूट्यूब से देख लिया और पीयर प्रेशर में आके आपने प्रेपरेशन को स्टार्ट कर दिया, तो उस तरीके के प्रेशर में आके आपको नहीं करना है. और रही बात सोसाइटी की, दे आर डूइंग देयर ओन जॉब, व्हाट यू हैव टू डू इज यू हैव टू डू योर जॉब. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि आप क्यों आए हैं सिविल सर्विसेज में करने के लिए, वो आपको पता होना चाहिए. और वो कैसे करना है सिर्फ वो आप जानते हैं. आई कैन कोट फ्रॉम वॉल्ट विटमैन हियर दैट नोबडी एल्स कैन ट्रैवल दैट रोड फॉर यू, यू हैव टू ट्रैवल इट फॉर योरसेल्फ. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू यू नो कीप दैट थिंग इन माइंड. सॉरी यूर इनऑडिबल स्मृति.
Ma'am, the next question, there's a suggestion. The person is asking for a suggestion. Kashish Arora is asking that I too failed in IIT JEE this year and I am confused between taking a drop and giving it again or do a BSc from Hansraj College. But my main goal is UPSC. So he's asking for your suggestion in this case.
Okay, see, if you can take a drop, you can give it again, because, you know, there is this fact that you didn't try your best. If you feel that you didn't give your best, you can try it again. Because otherwise, wo hamesha dimag mein rahega ki maine apna best nahi diya aur main kar sakta tha. So if you feel that you couldn't give your best in your previous attempt, you should give it again. Other than that, if your ultimate goal is to crack UPSC Civil Services Examination, you can try, come here. You will have this kind of environment here in the college, because now we have this amazing society where there's amazing peer group and amazing motivation and good people to guide you here. So is tarike ke environment mein agar aap try karenge for civil services, you can definitely go ahead with that as well. But I would suggest give your best to what you're looking forward to ultimately.
Now, I would like to ask another question. What is the role of answer writing and test series in our preparation, and when is the right time to start with them?
Okay, regarding test series, what usually happens is we start from day one and we get disheartened. This is the fact. Okay, we try to write answers. It might take us hours to write that one answer. And in the initial stages, we are aspiring for that perfect answer. That, okay, hum ye padke, hum ek perfect answer le denge. So there's this these two misconceptions, that for a perfect answer and to write answer from the day one. So I think these are the two challenges or two mistakes that you should not do. Now coming to another part, how to approach answer writing. It's just like biryani, you know, there's this content, there's this, you know, presentation, there's this amazing flavors like facts that you have to add, like quotes, data, everything like that. So when you cook biryani, you have to do preparation before that. You have to chop vegetables. And just like that, you have to build your foundation. You have to build that base, you know. To uske liye aapko hamesha kya karna hoga? Ki aapko apna jo content hai, at least have at least two basic readings of your book. Try to understand the demand of the syllabus, what UPSC is expecting from you, and then start answer writing. And regarding the importance of test series for answer writing, it's very important in the sense that it will give you that real-time experience of writing for 3 hours. And it will give you that sort of motivation as well. Because when you have a plan, you stay motivated, you stay disciplined. Because the test series are mainly for, you know, to stay in the preparation as a disciplined candidate, as well as to improvise continuously. So these are the two important role of a test series. So regarding test series ka marks, don't get disheartened with the marks. If you're getting low marks, just don't get disheartened, because they are not reflecting your real marks. At the end, what will matter is the UPSC ka marks. So uske liye aapko kya karna hai, ki aapko continuously strive karna hai ki jo previous wala test tha, usse better karna hai. Rather than looking to other people, what they are doing, just focus on your own preparation, your own strategy, what you have built for yourself. So focus on that very importantly. And don't start it from day one. Build your content first, then come to the part of presentation, time management, handwriting, quotes, data, facts. A lot of things goes into answer writing. Then focus on that. But before that, build your content.
Question is, what do you recommend, having a comprehensive preparation for all the 3 stages of the examination or going by gradational process?
See, ultimately what you have to do is to clear all the 3 stages. So basically what you have to do is, each of the stage of this examination demands something different from you, and therein lies the challenges that will be coming in your way. For example, prelims might test your factual data learning skills, as well as your analytical skills, as well as how you are updated with the current affairs. But at the same time, when you come to answer writing, it's more than knowledge. While we think that mains is about knowledge, it's more than knowledge. It's also a test of patience. It's also a test of your physical stamina as well, because you will be writing 2 papers in a day, and it's very difficult to write for 6 hours continuously. And uske beech mein 3 hours तो उसको भी सर्वाइव करना होता है, एंड फॉर 5 long days. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि यहाँ पे सिर्फ आपका नॉलेज का टेस्ट नहीं हो रहा है. देन कम्स दी पर्सनालिटी टेस्ट. सो देयर दे टेस्ट योर पर्सनालिटी, इफ यू आर सूटेबल फॉर द सिविल सर्विसेज और नॉट. सो हर एक स्टेज का एक डिफरेंट आस्पेक्ट है आपकी पर्सनालिटी का जो टेस्ट हो रहा है, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दी नॉलेज दैट ऑब्वियसली इज बीइंग चेक्ड अल्टीमेटली एट द प्रिलिमिनरी स्टेज. देन देयर आर डिफरेंट थिंग्स व्हिच हैव बीन टेस्टेड एट डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ दिस एग्जामिनेशन. तो रिगार्डिंग प्रीलिम्स और मेंस का प्रिपरेशन, मैं कह सकती हूँ कि काफी हद तक इंटीग्रेटेड है. इन द सेंस, पेपर काफी डायनामिक हो रहा है, पेपर काफी चेंज हो रहा है. नाउ द क्वेश्चंस आर नॉट अबाउट दोज वन लाइनर का क्वेश्चन, दे आर अबाउट 4 statements, 5 statements का क्वेश्चन. सो व्हाट दे आर ट्राइंग टू डू इज हियर इज दे आर ट्राइंग टू चेक योर नॉलेज इन डेप्थ. They are trying to analyze your analytical skills. So, आपको हर एक aspect पे आपको काम करना है. कि किस तरीके से आपको प्रेपरेशन करना है. देन आप सिमिलर फैक्ट्स जो आप प्रीलिम्स में यूज करते हो वो आप मेंस में डाल सकते हो, लाइक रिगार्डिंग एंशियंट हिस्ट्री, मॉडर्न हिस्ट्री, आप उसको उसमें यूज कर सकते हो कोर्स डेटा फैक्ट में. सिमिलरली एस एम में एथिक्स का यूज कर सकते हो. तो एक एक इंटीग्रेटेड प्रेपरेशन वैसे जाता है ओवरऑल प्रेपरेशन का, बट एट द सेम टाइम आपको अंडरस्टैंड करना होगा कि हर एक स्टेज का डिफरेंट चैलेंज है, हर एक स्टेज का डिफरेंट डिमांड है. अब टेस्ट सीरीज का इम्पोर्टेंस इज वे मोर इन प्रीलिम्स. क्यों? क्योंकि आपको वो जो है समझना होगा कि किस तरीके से आपको 2 hours में वो पेपर जो है कैसे सॉल्व करना है, आपके लिए नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कितना सूटेबल है, कि इतने नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस जब आप अटेम्प्ट करते हैं तो आपका पीक परफॉर्मेंस होता है. सिमिलरली फॉर मेंस आपको अंडरस्टैंड करना होगा कि आप 3 hours में आप टाइम मैनेजमेंट कर पा रहे हैं कि नहीं, आप क्वालिटी कॉन्टेंट उसमें डाल पा रहे हैं कि नहीं, आप अपना प्रेजेंटेशन मेंटेन कर पा रहे हैं कि नहीं. एंड आप उस 3rd day पे जब एथिक्स का पेपर होगा सबसे लास्ट, उस 5th paper में अपना कॉन्स्टेंट मोटिवेशन के साथ आप वो कर पा रहे हैं कि नहीं. तो एक इस तरीके से आप जर्नी में आपको जाना पड़ेगा.
So ask one last question for this session. What do you think is your key to success in the examination, and what advice would you like to give to the aspirants who will be taking up the competitive exam in the future?
My key to the success in the civil services examination would be dedication and consistency. This is, I can say, that I was disciplined throughout my preparation. Even if it was Diwali holidays, it was never holiday for me. Basically I was throughout consistently studied, you know. It was never like I was studying for 7 hours a day and then nothing at all the next day. I was very consistent in my preparation, and I can say, you know, today that these are the 2 important factors in my success today. And apart from that, this examination is also about luck, which we should not forget, that there are a lot of people who were there with me at the personality stage and who are equally or maybe more capable than me and who could not qualify. And I respect them, and it's very important to, you know, consider this factor of luck as well here in this examination of civil services, because a lot of people are preparing, a lot of people are appearing at this exam, and many don't make it. So we have to understand this thing as well, that we cannot, you know, just say that, okay, I did it. There are a lot of factors which are not in our hands, but at the same time, it works somehow. So, but you should be, you know, settled down in your mind that, okay, you gave your best and ultimately the results are here. And regarding my advice to everyone, this would be my advice that, okay, you have to be consistent and disciplined in your preparation. You have to stay motivated internally, you know, rather than getting motivated externally. If you are trying to find out that motivation externally, then maybe this is not the right path that you are looking towards. You have to understand that it should come from within you. It is your journey. It is who is going to create that story of yours. So focus on that. And regarding the civil services or any other goal that you are aspiring towards, that you are focusing towards, my only advice is pursue it with 100% honesty. Don't give it, you know, 50-50 main kar leta hun just for the sake of doing it. Nahin. And kyunki a question I saw about the backup plan, sometimes what happens is us backup plan ke chakkar mein we fail to pursue our plan A. So it's important that you at least give, if you are trying for civil services, at least give 2 wholehearted attempts before moving on to something else, before moving on to a backup plan. This I can say because examination, kabhi kabhi aise hota hai ki there are certain factors which might not work for you in one time and they might work for you in another time, another chance. So take that chance as well. So it's important to give at least 2 attempts, a wholehearted preparation with utmost honesty and dedication. This is my advice to all of you. Smriti, again, you are not audible.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for an insightful talk. Now I would like to express a vote of thanks on behalf of the entire team of NISHTHA. I express my most sincere thanks to Nidhi ma'am for gracing this event with her benign presence. I also want to thank our principal, Dr. Rama Men, and convener, Dr. Mahindra Prajapati sir, for always motivating and supporting us. Next, I would like to extend my gratitude to all the attendees who managed to be a part of this cult. Before culminating this event, I very humble thanks to our president of our society, Mr. Sunil Singer, for providing us this opportunity of hosting such an informative session. With this note, I would like to announce the successful conclusion of our second to none event eviction. Thank you all for making this event a resounding success. For more of the upcoming sessions and videos, do like and subscribe our social media handles. Thank you, ma'am. With this, we end the session. Thank you all.